price for foreigners who cannot speak Chinese at all. You end up spending 500 RMB on something that should cost you less than 100 RMB.
That shit hurting.
I know. Give me good vibes, something real. I forgot what it feels like. I had the late night strippers and the fake eyes. Made me realize I want something real. What it do, baby? Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, make sure you comment, like, and subscribe, and turn on your post notifications by clicking the bell over there. So, I'm going to talk about the things you need to know if you want to tour Beijing. If you're within China and you want to tour Beijing, or if you're outside China and you want to tour Beijing, like some of like the stuff I know. So first things first, you might want to book your apartment, your hotel in advance before you come, because you'll be looking for a hotel the same day you come, and it's going to be very, very, very expensive, you know. It goes up to 2,000 a night, 500 a night, 400 a night. But the best thing you can do is when you're traveling in groups, you can like use Airbnb, get an Airbnb apartment, and then it's going to be cheaper for you. For example, my friend's family came over to Beijing, and they were five of them. No, there were six of them when they came, and plus me, we were seven, and we tried to look for a hotel the same day and we couldn't find one because they were just so, so expensive. But we got Airbnb for 750 RMB for a night, and that's cheaper than being in a hotel, because as you know, each person, like two people, will have to share a room and it's going to be expensive. So yeah, that's one thing. Number two is, if you're going to buy tickets for a place like the Forbidden City, right? You're going to need to get your ticket 2 days before. Like, yeah, 2 days prior to visiting the Forbidden City. Reason being, the Forbidden City is one of the most visited places in Beijing. And mind you, the population is vast. It's huge. Like, there are a lot of people. I know you'd be asking yourself, like, oh, these people haven't really seen the Forbidden City or something like that. Yeah, because most people travel from outside Beijing to come and see the Forbidden City. Each day they have about 2,000 people plus. They have a few tickets that they sell at the Forbidden City, but they don't last long because people queue up for a very long time. And unlike other sites you want to visit, the Forbidden City requires you to go with your passport. They require your passport because it's one of like very, very important places. It's kind of like a government thing, you know. So it's really like that. And another thing is, the security is very tight. You have to go through security check because there are a lot of people, like a lot of people. So you have to go through your security check, and just like other most places that you visit, you have to go through security check. But for others, you don't really need to go through security check. And your student card comes in handy. If you're a student in China, you get a lot of discounts by showing your student booklet or your student card. In this case, my student card is attached to my transport card. But this transport card can only work within Beijing. So I can use the Beijing metro station, and I can use buses in Beijing. But if you are touring and you want to move around, there are certain sites and places you can go just by using the metro. You don't need to take a bus, you don't need to take a taxi and whatnot. So it's really convenient, you know. But you can buy a metro card at the Beijing subway station, and if you're done using it, you're about to leave, you can take it back there and you'll be refunded the money that you paid for the card. And how you get around Beijing? Well, you can use the Didi app, but Didi is quite a bit expensive. So there's this app called Dida. It's in Chinese though, so your Chinese is supposed to be really, really good. You're supposed to be able to read your Chinese. And to get around Beijing, you need to know your basic Chinese. Okay, to get around China, basically, you need to know your basic Chinese. Reason being is, if you go and buy something, you go to a market or something, first of all, they have prices for locals, for the local people.
That's the cheap one. Then they have a price for foreigners who can speak Chinese. It's a bit higher than the local price. And then they have a price for foreigners who cannot speak Chinese at all. You end up spending 500 RMB on something that should cost you less than 100 RMB.
That shit hurting.
I know. It's really stressful. It's one of those things. So you need to make sure you speak at least basic Chinese. And also, like, to get around, you can use the buses. Like, each bus is numbered. That's one thing I really like about China. Each bus is numbered and it's got its routes. It's got its own routes that it takes, right? So, for example, if you need to take a bus, maybe you need to go somewhere. And the best thing I'd advise you to do is check how to get there via metro. And through the metro, you can check Google how to get there. Or you can use the Chinese map, how to get there. You can use, Baidu maps, right? And you can check how to get there. And then when you check, it will show you if you use the metro, which stop you use, which stop you're going to take. And from there, which exit, the direction you take afterwards, how long you walk, and which bus you take. So, right, you don't really have to be scared that if I take this bus, I may not go to this place, right? And then if you're not sure about where you're going, if you can't read Chinese, like, you, if you know the name of the stop where you're going, you can ask the attendant, the transport officer. Yeah, we have conductors here too. You can ask the transport officer if the stop is nearby, or where the stop is, after how many stops is your stop, and they'll let you know about that. And then you can also ride bikes around. You have bikes like Mobike, Hello Bike, you have Ofo, and other brands of bicycles. For those bicycles, you need to download an app. And if you download an app, you can just scan the QR code on the bike. Go into the app, open the app, scan the QR code on the app, and then they'll send you a password. And then you unlock the bike and you can ride them. And when you're done, you can just lock it and cancel or end your ride, right? It works like that. And then you have different organizations that arrange trips. Like, for example, there's CET trips. It organizes trips. Like, for example, if you want to go to Inner Mongolia, if you want to go to the Avatar Mountains, if you want to go to the Glass Bridge, the Great Wall, if you want to go to the Beijing Wax Museum, if you want to go to the aquarium, to the zoo, if you want to go to, like, different places. So you can, like, find out more about this app, about these people and what they do, and you can get their contact. And on their WeChat, they always share moments on the next trips, how much they are, and sometimes you get discounts if you buy 3 tickets at once or 4 tickets at once. So it's one of those things. And if you're going to tour Beijing, you can also use another mode of transport. You can use pedicabs. You have those if you're going to tour around the Hutong area, also known as Old Beijing, right? You can use those pedicabs. They are quite pricey, but it's okay. And then another mode of transport you can use to get around, like, if, for example, if there's so much traffic, you can use the tuk-tuks. They are around everywhere. And if you need, like, if you're starving or you need something, there's always, like, street food around, and you can buy the street food, right? So those are some of the things you need to know about Beijing. That's if you want to tour Beijing. And then also you can buy your movie tickets online in advance. You can buy a number of tickets in advance on your WeChat, because when you're in China, WeChat serves a lot of purposes. You can pay your bills, you can send money and receive money, you can do this and that, compared to when you're using it outside China, like back home and so on and so forth. So yeah, we've officially come to the end of the video. Let me know what your thoughts are. Make sure you comment, like, and subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.